With a heart that is desperate, and I cry, wanting just to be heard by you, and I pray that you won't remain silent, that you'll stand here beside me, that my heart won't call out in vain. It's all I want. With a heart that is hungry, and I sing, wanting you just to know my love, and I pray that my life will be counted for the sake of your kingdom, that my heart will be truly yours, 'cause all I want
Yeah, I mean, we've got to get to the point in our lives where we actually believe that God and His desires for us are truly the things that are going to make us happiest, give us the most peace, and satisfy our souls deeply. When we talk about this, and we know in our minds that it's true, somehow these beliefs, they don't make their way into our everyday lives. I mean, if they did, wouldn't we be different? Wouldn't we act different? Wouldn't we talk different? I don't think it's because we don't want to be happy or that we're trying to sabotage our own lives. Maybe we just don't really trust God. We've got to decide that no matter what the cost, we want to be satisfied in God alone and Him alone. And aren't you tired of reading your Bible because you feel you have to? I want to love Jesus. I want to long to spend time with Him. I want to get up in the morning and can't wait to be with Him. And anything in my life that is more exciting or more valuable to me than God, that thing's an idol. I don't want it to be like that. I want to be like John Piper said in The Pleasures of God. God is most glorified in us when we are most satisfied in Him. I want God to be glorified. So I want to see what I can do to be most satisfied in Him.